That's why I've asked the Nuclear Regulatory Commission to do a comprehensive review of the safety of our domestic nuclear plants in light of the natural disaster that unfolded in Japan. Finally, we are working aggressively to support our Japanese ally at this time of extraordinary challenge. Search and rescue teams are on the ground in Japan to help the recovery effort. A disaster assistance and response team is working to confront the aftermath of the earthquake and tsunami. The U.S. military, which has helped to ensure the security of Japan for decades, is working around the clock. To date, we've flown hundreds of missions to support the recovery efforts and distributed thousands of pounds of food and water to the Japanese people. We've also deployed damage at Japan's nuclear reactors. We're sharing with them expertise, equipment, and technology so that the greatest responders on the scene have the benefit of American teamwork and support. And the American people have also opened up their hearts. Many have given generously to support the ongoing relief efforts. The Red Cross is providing assistance to help meet the immediate needs of those who've been displaced. And I would encourage anybody who wants to lend a hand to go to usaid.gov to learn more. That's usaid.gov to find out how you can be helpful. As I told Prime Minister Khan last night and reaffirmed at the Japanese embassy here in Washington today, the Japanese people are not alone in this time of great trial and sorrow. Across the Pacific, they will find a hand of support extended from the United States as they get back on their feet. After all, we have an alliance that was forged more than half a century ago, that's strengthened by shared interests and democratic values. Our people share ties of family, ties of culture, and ties of commerce. Our troops have served to protect Japan's shores, and our citizens have found opportunity and friendship in Japan's cities and towns. Above all, I am confident that Japan will recover and rebuild, because the strength and spirit of the Japanese people. Over the last few days, they've opened up their homes to one another. They've shared scarce resources, food, and water. They've organized shelters, provided free medical care, and looked out for their most vulnerable citizens. One man put it simply, it's a Japanese thing. When hard times hit, we have to help each other. In these hard times, there remains, nevertheless, hope for the future. In one small town that had been flattened by the tsunami, emergency workers rescued a four-month-old baby who had been swept out of her parents' arms and stranded for days among the debris. No one can say for certain just how she survived the water and the wreckage around her. There is a mystery in the course of human events, but in the midst of economic recovery and global upheaval, disasters like this